over to our final match. That match ended just in time. A very impressive match it was. But we also have the final match of today, which is going to be Germany versus the United States. We should be getting into this one in just a moment, and they have their warm-ups ready. It looks like the first warm-up is going to be a Tadish song, and that is Reunion.
I've always liked Reunion. It's a cool song.
Indeed, and you know, it definitely has the right feel for as pumped as I am right now. That last match had me pumped, and the pump feeling is not going away, and this song kind of puts that out beautifully.
Yeah, I can't remember, you were around the whole thing, yeah? Because you showed up, like, 5-3?
I showed up at 5-2.
Yeah.
God, you got to see the best part of the match then.
Yeah. My darn alarm didn't go off. I set it for 20 minutes to get another small nap in, and my cat was like, no speakers for you. Click.
Chiba, why?
She pulled the cord right out of them. When I did come to, I just see my screen like blinking, telling me, hey, your alarm. And I'm like, oh no.
$10.05. Oh, goody.
This'll end well.
Ho, it's good to see that both sides have got their powerhouses out. Seeing Itzy V2 on the United States side is a pretty big confidence booster for all you Burger fans out there, I'm pretty sure.
Let's see how this thing plays out.
Okay, so, any early guesses for this match? Or are you just both gonna jump straight onto the US bandwagon?
I actually think Germany's got a slight edge here. United States is a very scary team, don't get me wrong, but based on past performance records, I don't know. I reckon the Germans could give them slightly more than just a regular run for their money here.
Yeah, you know, unfortunately, US, like, we got a good CPB team, or Ozcatch team, but I feel like we might get outdone. I feel like we could possibly make it to the finals, but I don't foresee it. Only time will tell, and hopefully this match will give us a little bit of insight here. This is a winner bracket encounter, so they are still up in the winner's bracket, so this might take them to the loser's bracket. Well, one of these teams is going to the loser's bracket.
Yeah, so one of these teams will go down the loser's bracket, and the other will advance into a guaranteed top three, and we are not going to sing this.
Sorry, Jimmy, not this time. This is the wrong World Cup for our singing commentators.
Sorry, not sorry. Yeah, this is... Do you want us to sing something? You'd have to wait till we're in the Elf Idol or something, but I can't see that happening.
Sorry, not sorry.
Dietrich, go sing in the Elf Idol. Have it. Do it.
I do the example songs every year. Like,
it's just not the same.
I pretty much got roped into judging for it permanently, so I don't think I'll ever be able to take part in it, which is a sad day. I almost won one of them way back before we started doing them all officially and stuff, which I wouldn't win an official one for sure. There's too many talented vocalists in there that have been back from years prior that are just gonna clean my clock.
Yeah, because we were talking about it earlier, because we saw a warm-up that was the Yelena and Charlotte cover of... Yeah.
Takashi Goto.
Two are very talented, and...
Oh, that's scary.
Yeah.
There's Captain Hampton, actually.
Captain Hampton's not bad at all. I didn't...
But yeah, I do have to hand it to Charlotte and Yelena. Go on.
I didn't hear any lousy trap. That's pretty good demo song to do. Anyways, that aside, let's watch this warm-up as we see both teams are playing pretty well, and if they were watching the previous match, they have to be fired up themselves, as that was just something that gets the blood flowing.
Yeah, I mean, to follow up a match like that, just...
I wanted to be fired up with Warrior. They know that if they win this, they're going to go up against Indonesia next weekend.
Indonesia is an incredibly scary team. As a matter of fact, both teams on screen right now are incredibly frightening in their own ways. It's just, unfortunately, if they do have a bit of a habit of underperforming. It's a very strange disease that seems to have rankled both of them, but if they can just pull themselves up above that, we could see, I mean, an unbelievable match here. Not that I expect to see a one-sided encounter by any means. Flutter going ham. Oh, and I cursed it. Good job, me.
Definitely an exciting map here. This is something that you definitely want to see as a warm-up for this kind of stage. It does look like the United States was able to pull that at the very end, but of course these are just warm-ups.
Yeah, these sort of maps still...
I was going to say, they still do give like a small indication of how the matches could turn out though.
Well, I suppose, yeah, to a certain extent. These maps are usually a few levels above what you'd expect to see in the pool, and that can really be a... Oh, good God, what is this?
Oh, no.
Well, this is gonna go fantastically.
Oh, look at that. He's actually...
I'm done.
Okay, well, Zedrop dies in the corner. Rip Zedrop. Arthur, you're alive. Yes, Arthur's alive. Okay, so at least one of the Americans is still alive. So that's something.
What am I listening to?
I don't even know.
There is definitely SpongeBob in the background of that.
It is. Yeah, that's SpongeBob.
This has got to be the U.S. warm-up. But that being said, Zach doesn't know what this is, so... Wait, what?
Oh, God!
What? What just happened? Oh my God. What is this? Who even picked this?
I'm pretty
sure this is the most troll song we've ever had.
Who picked this?
I don't know!
Germany.
For real?
Yep.
See, I thought it was American, and Zach was saying, nope. Like, what? What is this? I was like, they didn't pick this? What?
Yeah, this does sound like something Jimmy Rustler would pick, though.
Psych. Oh, goodness gracious.
Oh, that's, is this one of these maps?
Oh, wow, they're not gonna move at all.
Yeah, I think...
they're just holding up... Oh, man, if only they could have changed the skin to have Yuzu just holding up his boombox. It's just like, guys, we need you to hear our crappy anthem for a moment. This is what we wanted to hear right before we get into our... crazy battle today.
Well, it's one way of getting yourself invigorated.
What was that?
SpongeBob. Oh, good god, the distortion.
This song is... What?
It's glorious. This is glorious.
That's one word for it, I guess.
Come on, Chad, give me some Bible thumps. This song deserves it. Oh god, a tear is coming to my eye. And a red tear from my ears.
Sounds about right.
God, that's psych. Every time.
I do like the psych. It's quite fun. It's a nice touch.
It is.
It's a nice transition between songs. Rather than just like your standard fade in, fade out, and it's psych.
Oh no!
Oh god, is that? No.
They totally, there's not a single note in the middle, so they can literally stand in the center and have a perfect zero accuracy.
The map is on, there's still a third note.
What?
Locktab, what on earth are we listening to?
Oh yeah, I'm with Locktab, I have no idea. What is this?
Psych!
Psych every time, man!
What? No, please. There's only so much I can handle. Yeah, that I definitely know.
That gets you got a pretty high score.
Good heavens, I don't think I'll be forgetting that warm up for a while.
Oh, my chest.
That was definitely something.
Someone's been to the wrong side of the internet, I can see.
All right.
Yeah, so we're just gonna swap to this for a little bit.
We go straight to da 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 da. We're not actually playing that. I'm not sure if we are. We just
said one of them.
Oh shoot, he won.
What?
All right, but we just switched to this in order to take that song off. So the bans are still happening. This could very well be banned. We don't know. So give it a little bit of time.
Yeah, we're just giving some time for our ears to heal, and while we're at it, we'll check out what the bands are.
That being said, I am going to get myself a glass of water. I need something after that. I haven't laughed that hard. I even... much.
Ooh, they banned out two CTV specific maps. Interesting.
Yeah, probably Hard Rock, I believe.
Isn't one of them no? Let me just check that really quickly.
Can I just put Hard Rock?
Oh yeah, you are correct. Both Hard Rock. And US banning DT Sumidagawa and Nomad Avalon Naoka.
But what was it? Sumidagawa and Avalon were it. A
Interestingly, they banned up Evolom. I would have thought some of their bans would have been for Hidden. Alright.
Well, you do, yeah, you do bring up a good point there. Maybe they're not sure if Germany can play those hidden picks either. Perhaps both teams have just elected not to, you know, touch those maps. Oh, I do believe we have our next map picked. Excellent.
Okay, what about we have? Oh, believe. All right, excellent. This is definitely one of the more popular double time picks.
Yeah, in the last match we saw both teams did seem pretty well set on it. There were a few mishaps near the end, but outside of that, it seemed overall a lot more accessible than maybe some of the other stuff that we've got in there. Yeah, it is AR 10.3 though, if I'm not mistaken.
All right, so we still gonna go for? You still gonna give the edge to Germany here?
All right, it looks like we're gonna have some.
I think
double
so.
Time. Cedric, what about you? Still gonna go for Germany, or are you gonna go for US?
I feel like the US might be able to do something, but let's give it a couple points on the board before I start throwing my opinion.
All right, well, to start this off, it looks like we actually have Kirisu and Itzy going with the hidden to go with their double time, along with Nope Karoi and Rico, who will actually be the first to miss here.
Yeah, Rico starting us off with a couple of early breaks. Oh, three right before the first break. Oh, Rico is really struggling with this map. It does not seem to be his speed at all. Perhaps a transition to DT from the warm-up, or rather from the lack of warm-up, wasn't
it
quite...
It could also be the hidden. That could be thrown off as well.
Well, considering the hidden is optional, you'd think he wouldn't have gone with the hidden if it had thrown him off. It is approach rate 10.3 hidden, though, so... Yeah, Note Kuroi has actually also missed, along with Kurisu on the United States side, so that leaves... Ooh, Itzy just missed, so my statement was invalidated before I even said it. Dell and Flutter, the only ones still holding FCs, and that's really... You've come to expect that, really. Flutter able to play pretty much everything decently. Oh, he does. Or they do break there, leaving Dell the last man standing, and being a DT specialist, he really is. I mean, he throws double time on everything. There are some maps where he's the only one with a double time or hidden double time score. He does finally break, though, leaving the highest combos to Kurisu and Itzy, his teammates. No Kuroi bringing back up his combo, but his teammates not quite able to get the hang of it yet.
Yeah, Kurisu drops from Rico. Itzy as well dropping there. But things are looking good for the United States at the moment. As long as Kurisu can hold that, Dell is starting to have a decent combo back as well, and Itzy is even crowned into the 100 mark. Rico and Flutter having problems getting under the 100 combo there. No Kuroi also did just drop.
Yeah, I mean, this is looking pretty good for US. I mean, they've got about a 250, 300k lead.
I think that was the latest. Sorry.
Latest one, sorry?
Was that just me, or did anyone else just see the title of the song appear like halfway through the map?
I
guess that was just me.
Maybe, yeah. But I mean, looking back at the score again, like, it was about 300k, and now it's getting up to 500, so US are just steamrolling ahead here. Kurisu just... Okay, well, never mind. I'm sorry. I've cursed Kurisu, who was actually doing really well there. Until I decided to curse him, so... That itself isn't so good, but either way, even with that unfortunate miss, it does look like this is going to be a first point to the United States with about a 600-plus-k lead here. And Germany still struggling to hold a bit of a high combo, so not so good for them there. So yeah, that is going to be 1-0 to United States, with Germany taking the next pick. So let's have a quick look here, actually. So US band won double time in a no mod. So I don't think there's enough bands to warrant targeting a specific sort of bracket. They banned out two hard rock, so I don't think they'll go for hard rock. I'm not sure if hidden's the best idea either. I think US have a pretty good hidden, so yeah. They're gonna go for no mod, which was, yeah, Story of the Legendary Sword. Sounds good. Again, keeping that 100% pick rate going. Oh, that's not good. That is not good. Oh dear. I've just noticed something. Looking at who's picked this, statistically speaking, whoever picks this loses. Hong Kong picked it, they lost. France picked it. Oh no, France picked it, they won, so. Poland picked it, they lost. Argentina picked it, they lost. Singapore picked it, they won, so it's 2-3 so far. Sorry, 2-5. So. Hopefully, Germany will still be fine here. I mean, then again, it is just a little silly stat, so we'll see how things go for them here. All right, so here we go with our second match. Is this going to go to 1-1, or will US take their second point here? Pretty good start for both teams here. No actually loss from either side, so I guess we'll just have to wait to see where the first miss will come from. That being said, I don't think any of these teams will be in any mad rush. Both will definitely be wanting to look to hold on to their combos for as long as they can. Quarter of the way through the map, and we still have not yet seen that first break, except there we go. Vincey from Germany claiming their first miss of their game, giving the lead over to the United States. We're about a third of the way through the map, and there's still not that much of a lead. I mean, the lead's still gonna go quite a bit from pairing out, since it was a fairly recent miss, so there is still time for Germany to make a comeback if Mercury Flutter and Vincey can keep their combo going. But it will heavily rely on someone from the US team missing, and I'm not sure if they're gonna want to do that so easily. As we pass the halfway point, and US is still looking pretty good here.
We have seen some last moment fails on this map, so it's still gonna be anyone's game.
Oh yeah, very much so. I mean, it's not over just yet. We've still got about a third of the map, a quarter of the map left. That also being said, the US do have about a 200,000 point lead, so it's not a safe lead, but it's a pretty good lead for now. And yep, they're gonna hold the combo, and this is looking pretty good. I think they're about 300k lead. I think even if one of their players, one of the US players miss, I think they'll still have this. I don't think enough time left, and yeah, Carisu missing right at the end, but no matter, that is still going to be a second point. Oh, he actually almost failed there.
That was very lucky on his end. That was
almost death. If he actually failed it, that would have been horribly unlucky. I was like, oh yeah, US have got this. It's like 2 seconds left, whatever. Oh.
That would have been disastrous, because... Was it this map that someone failed on in, like, the last 2 seconds and it gave the point to someone else?
That was the match just earlier, if I'm not mistaken.
Also, Flutter and Jimmy Rustler, perfect score. No... points off as well. I mean, there was like a 300k score gap, but...
You kind of went over to the Autobot.
Whoops.
You're good now. It's clean.
That was red.
Twitch chat is just telling you a little bit of robot love.
Love you too, Twitch chat. Alright, well, moving away from that little hiccup there. We are going to move on because I believe this is now the United States' second pick, so...
It was. And that was confirmed. The match that Intensity lost on was the China vs. Fallen match, and we lost with the last 2 seconds.
Right, yeah. And looks like we're going to be going full legend. So, US are up 2-0 now. What are you thinking about how this match is turning out? Are you happy?
I'm a little happy, yeah, but I do feel like maybe Germany should have used their time in their warm-up to warm up a little bit. It seems to be affecting them.
I think they wouldn't have done that if they weren't confident, so...
But confidence is not always the best thing to have.
Yeah, I suppose there is overconfidence, which is definitely something you don't want to have.
Alright, and we should be getting started with Legend now.
Yeah, so this is definitely another one of the more popular picks. This is the fifth time this has actually been picked up now, I'm afraid. So, definitely one of the more popular no mods, or just general pickups in general, really. The only other mat that's close to this is what we just saw, Story of the Legendary Sword, which has been picked up in every match. But looking at this match in particular, it looks like the United States are actually off to a pretty early lead here, as Flutter seems to be having a bit of trouble holding a combo, but we do also have Carisu on the United States team actually missing, so this is a bit of a chance for Germany to catch up, but again, Flutter just not being able to hold that combo or any combo of any sort. He is really struggling here, unfortunately, as Carisu does in fact seem to be able to pull himself back together and get his combo back over 100, so he should be pretty good now, I reckon.
Yeah, it does look like he's going to be able to pull up there very well. Vincey and Nolan Roy holding him kind of doing well, but with Flutter constantly breaking, that's not good. But Carisu and Jimmy Rustler have also lost the combo. This will give Germany a chance to take the lead, as Nolan Roy and Vincey are both holding strong. So as long as we don't see a drop from Vincey or Nolan Roy, this might actually be a victory for Germany here.
Well, we're not going to see a miss from them, but we're definitely going to see one from Flutter, so it's not going to matter too much, I don't think. I mean,
So, at the very end here, this could be a potential comeback. Very possible.
Yeah, especially with Vincey missing, that one was one of the bigger combos. It does look like United States are actually coming back. Can they actually do it, though? Flutter actually missing again? And what's it going to be? Who's going to take it?
It looks like it's just barely gonna go over.
12,000 points of difference. That is
pretty close. I am. Yeah, so this is going to be a pretty close match, and it looks like we do have our third person coming back. Hello there.
Hello, I'm third person.
Welcome back, third person.
It's been a long time, like somewhere around
you.
3 minutes.
You also missed some pretty crazy stuff, unless you were watching. And if you were watching, then you know exactly what just happened there. Germany was able to get the first point on the board at a very
I was watching it.
Yeah, very unfortunate that at the end the United States had one fail there. Oh, but the score did get submitted fine, so no, they just got beat out all fair and square style.
Yeah, definitely for full score submissions from either one. So it went by 1,984 points. Pretty close. I think if the US had just a little bit more time, they could have made that 3-0. They almost had that comeback.
Alright, and it looks like we're going to be going with da-da-da-da next.
Yudaso?
No, da-da-da-da-da-da. We actually haven't seen this that much. This is only the second time it's been picked up now.
Which is surprising, because it was all the rave in the last World Cups we've seen it in, and it always starts a huge wave of da-da-da-da's from the Twitch chat, so you can definitely see that they love it.
Yeah, Twitch chat loves this song. Isn't that right, Twitch chat? You love this. Yeah, so this is definitely a German pick. Do you think this was the right German pick to go for? Or do you think they could have potentially tried for a risky... Maybe not risky, but for a double jump pick?
I feel like Germany obviously got to know what they're doing here, but at the same time, with how close it was to winning their first point, I don't know if this is a good idea to pick. It feels like this is something the United States would have definitely practiced.
So it feels like they, another thing that US, not US, Jimmy could try for if they really wanted to, was to be something like Hungarian dance number 5, maybe? Just like a quick in and out double time pick. It's definitely something to consider, maybe, or while to think about. But for now, it looks like we're just waiting for the last few players to ready up, and we should be good to go.
All right.
And here we go.
Yeah, it does look like we are underway with our fourth pick. Da 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 da. I probably threw way too many dots in there, but...
$10.
$10, $20, it's all the same.
The same.
Yeah, it's all the same. Anyway, just look at this score flicker! That is a good start.
There's like no difference. Oh, Bingxi. Huge drops over there. And same for Dell, actually. It's Germany, the team is in the lead.
On the same note. Oh no, yeah, so I think they missed on the same note, but then Dell missed again, and now Vinci has as well, so that lead should go over to their Saints if they can just keep this going. Because the lead isn't all that large, actually, from what I can see. I think if Dell Yeah, I think if you can keep your combo going, they should take the lead very shortly.
Yeah, well, I'm
Jimmy and Rossler.
Dropping there is not going to be great.
That's a huge drop, and Guri's do as well.
Combo for the US.
Yeah, this was a really good pick by Germany here.
Only Nautic, Kuroi, and Fluder keeping the full combo over there. Really nice performance over there by those two.
Yeah, the misses from Jimmy Rossler and Creator were huge, and no Kuroi and Flutter are still going seriously strong with those double hits. This match is just going to go back and forth, isn't it? Is this going to be Germany versus South Korea all over again?
It could be very possible.
I'm not sure I can handle it.
All right, and that is going to make the score to all. So we will see who's going to take the first point and break away from this mini tie we have at the moment. It is in the United States court, so hopefully they will pick something that they are able to take point on.
I mean, and Del
asking how to Nomad.
Yeah, it was a pretty good start for the United States, but Germany has time to have a nice little comeback here. So, let's see what US are going to go from this, because, I mean, we might start seeing some of the hidden picks come out, because that's been completely untouched. No picks, no bans.
I think that's the strategy of Germany. I think Germany wants to bait United States to go for the hidden picks that are really risky, and try to get some points up because of that. Might be just me.
Then the United States could maybe try for Hard Rock? They could try for like Coffins?
If they can get a Nomad where Itzy plays, I think that should be good. Like, I'm not too sure why Itzy didn't play in this one. Seems like he played it too much with Hard Rock or something before. But with Itzy in the team, US should not have too many issues in the normal bracket. I wonder what they will go for right now though, because I don't see not any discussion, not nothing.
Well, Flu is saying 1 minute, but I'm not sure what he's going to ask him to say in a minute. I would have thought that, I was right? They got the Hard Rock.
Hard Rock, okay. Piranha's going to be then. Without Chicken Bible, that might be something that the US might lack a little bit of power on.
Yeah, that's not a very... I don't know. They might have this. They might have practiced it enough, but that's a definite dangerous thing to do without Chicken there.
Yep. I mean, having Dell on the team is always good in these kind of picks. Itzy is definitely going to be a difference as well. But the dream roster of US has Chicken Bible in the Hard Rock maps, and he is not present over here. He's not present. I'm not sure if that's the word, but you get it. Seems like Rico, though, will be joining the Germany side, replacing Bink. He's not around. Yeah, that's the word.
Choking is my life. That's not something you really want to hear right before you start the song.
Well, that might give you a good excuse if you end up choking, and you can just say, ha, I lied. If you just say, ha, I lied at the end of the song, if you didn't choke.
Okay. So it looks like we have Rico, Itzy, and Carissa going with the extra hidden, and Nokre with actually a very early miss, which is quite surprising, followed up by Rico, so... And Flutter, okay, Germany's already missed. That is not a good start for Germany. Okay, so it looks like, whoa, what happened to Itzy there?
Something.
Did you see that?
Yeah, he just misread it, well, this is a section where you have to not misread at all, because it can lead you into a triple fail if you're not concentrated enough. It's not looking like it will happen. Every single player here seems to know the map quite well. So only one drop so far in that section from Rico, and a good advantage in terms of scoring and combo for the US.
Yeah, it looks like we managed to pull that back.
That is true. I mean, the US do have just shy of 100,000 point lead here, so it is looking pretty good with, I think it's just Dell and Carissa with the full, okay, well maybe it's Carissa with the full combo, it is Dell Edge. He does miss there, sir.
But now there is a combo advantage in favor of Germany, so that might start to turn back a little bit in favor of Germany, because the song is quite long and you're still not into the second third of the map.
Yeah, I mean, we just had a third of the map, and yeah, there is a slight lead since I think Flutter does have about 100 combo on Itzy, so...
Yeah, but Dell has 100 combo on Rico. Rico is not doing a great job here.
That's huge.
That's a huge drop indeed from Flutter.
Yeah, that miss from Flutter is definitely gonna hurt. I mean, he was kind of keeping Jimmy in this along with no Corey, but with his combo gone, you know, I'd say Slater's just gonna start skyrocketing from here. It's already like gone up by another 100k, and I don't see that slowing down anytime soon.
Well, if a miss from Carissa happens, stuff can start to turn back a little bit. But as soon as they keep the combo for a longer time, it will be harder to catch up because the difference will be bigger and bigger. That's a miss from Itzy just before the break.
Yeah, it's not Carissa breaking who does it. You have the full combo. But it is still a little bit of a shame that you did break there.
Definitely, that means for the US.
Yeah, that means there's a 300k lead at the moment, so I think they can feel a little bit safe with their lead at the moment.
I think they have enough time if they find a proper timing miss by Itzy and Dell, but with a miss from Rico, the possibilities and the chances are getting lower and lower. Now, the only chance for them is a miss from Carissa, and if that doesn't happen, both Itzy and Dell has to break, and that is what just happened. So watch out a little bit. Carissa actually missing and dropping the combo out, and now
failed.
It's all about Nautic Roy. It's all about Nautic Roy keeping it a little bit longer, just a little. He's the only chance for Germany because it's the only combo that does matter at this point. And there's 200,000 leads still on favor of the US, and there's no much map left. He does have to keep that up until the end. There's no chance for the US to recover from that miss. And Germany is climbing back, and seems like they will be taking it at the end. But a miss from Nautic Roy, and actually a whole fail by him.
I don't know if he failed. I think he held on by a sliver of health. I don't know if he's out, but either way he's gonna recover, so that's not gonna matter at all. His score should be fine.
It doesn't matter at all though, because US is still on the lead because of that miss. It's the only reason, because Germany was not able to get back that lead into their hands, and at the end, US will be taking the third point.
Yeah, that was actually really close. I thought there would be a lot more in favor of US, but no, that was a really good match. But yeah, so with US taking the third point there, this is going to be Germany's next pick. So I wonder if they'll stick with the Nomad, or do you reckon they might try go for something else here?
Not exactly sure.
I'll say maybe double time, I don't know.
Double time, ooh.
Double time would definitely be something that's open and quick and easy to try to get back a point back.
Well, speaking of quick and easy, I was actually talking about Hungarian dance earlier, since that is just like a quick in and out.
Yeah, it's a real good way to get a decisive point or to try to bring something back, but it could also backfire.
Oh, heavily. But nope, they're going to go for Eastward. Alright, so do you think this is where Germany's chances lie? Do you think it's rests solely on some of these Gnomod picks?
Well, it already did work, but now they have Itzy, so good luck, I guess. It's going to be harder indeed, but they have a chance. If they're on pick, so they should at least practice with this one.
Because it is worth mentioning that after this, there's only one more Gnomod around, which is Oisama.
So Germany needs to go at least for one mob win in order to take the whole series. Which is funny is that Hidden is being absolutely ignored.
Yeah, I feel like both teams are just avoiding it out of just like, I don't feel safe enough with this. I think if this continues as it is though, they'll have to at some point go for the Hidden.
Yeah, it definitely will. Well, Dell is having a huge amount of issues here with this map. Okay, first miss there for Germany. Bingzi is the one missing over there. And Dell is starting to build up a little bit of combo in his favor. But now, as I said it, he ends up finding a miss. Advantage in terms of scoring and combo in favor of Germany at this point. Not Kuroi and Flutter, still with 100%. Same for Itzy and Jimmy Rustler. The fight pretty much is about Bingzi and Dell, and Dell is losing that fight by so much at this point that gives Germany a huge advantage.
Yeah, Dell is down
here. Oh, first miss from Jimmy Rustler over there. United States now is on the backside instead of combo. By a lot, and Itzy now finding a miss as well. Only not Kuroi and Flutter with the full combos remaining, standing still and going as ham as they can. And if they keep it for a little bit longer, it's just about surviving 400,000 points in favor of Germany at this point. And Itzy and Jimmy are still finding misses all the time in this normal pick. So if nothing like a fail happens, this is going to be a point for Germany.
Yep. Very much so. This is a very back and forth battle so far that we've seen.
Well, it seems like Flutter ended up finding a miss over there, but Note is still going. Kuroi getting not 100%, but a really amazing full combo until this section, and absolutely destroying the map.
Yeah, that was definitely
1 million points of difference.
Yeah, that was definitely one of the more one-sided matches we've seen.
But that is going to bring us to 3-all. And we have not seen that. We have not seen a back-and-forth rebuttal for teams this entire, the entirety of today.
Yeah, I was going to say, we've seen it before, but just not today. Yeah, I think the last time we saw this was Germany versus South Korea, which was round of 16. Actually, did we even see a tiebreaker last weekend? I don't think we did.
Mm.
Yeah, no, we didn't.
It was the closer one. It was Argentina-Japan.
Yeah, no, there was no tiebreaker last weekend. And yet here we might see a second one back to back.
Oh, that's crazy.
Just like, as you think about the fact that we might have back-to-back tiebreakers at the semi-finals.
Very true. That's just hype, though. I mean, we didn't have too many tiebreakers throughout the matches. We had a couple in group stage, if I'm not mistaken. But outside of that, we really haven't had too much.
No, we haven't. I think we've, like, 4 or 5 at the group stage. I could go check.
Yeah, outside of that, it kind of just, you know, kind of died down in terms of that.
Since the round of 16, there's been only one tiebreaker outside of the last match, which was, it was Germany vs. South Korea, which I'm sure a lot of people here will remember. Okay, do you want to take a quick guess at how many you were in the group stage?
Three of them?
Five.
Oh, there was five. Okay, wow.
Hong Kong vs South Korea. Japan vs Chile. Who else did we have? We had Taiwan vs France. New Zealand vs Mexico. And Mexico vs United States. Yeah. There were a few, which is quite good, but moving along from there, it looks like we have Inevitabilis?
Yep, yeah. That's looking like.
So yeah, the Hidden has emerged with... I was actually going to say it was Zach joining the room, but it looks like he popped in and left again.
Carissa's staying, Itzy's staying, it's probably going to be Zach. I mean, I don't see why why he shouldn't.
Good save there, Juan. Good save. Yeah, this Carissa. It does seem kind of weird from just like pop in, say the map, and then just like go poof again. So I guess we're just waiting for the last German and US player to join, sir. Wait, Zach is in the room?
Seems like he's not in the correct spot, but he is.
Yeah,
he's
gotta be. Ah, your creation's noticed as well. I was really confused. I was like, I can see him talking, but what?
Dude, I like that color. That.
What?
That gray. Notice his.
What?
Text is gray.
What?
Yeah, that happens when you are in the incorrect slot.
Yeah, when
you are in the room, but not in the correct slot.
Exactly. Do want?
Alright, so seems like we are ready to start with Inevitabilis.
So yeah, here comes the Hidden that we were waiting for. Who will prevail?
So far, it seems like US is on the lead because of MGN, T-Vi missing, Itzy and Flutter finding misses over there as well, but Zach and Kurizu still managed to hold the combo decently with 100%, not Kuroi being the only one in the Germany side.
I'm gonna call you Toby. No Kuroi, Flutter, and Toby.
I got Toby.
Sorry, that's Toby now. But yes, for Toby's unfortunate misses at the start of the map, United States are going to take a bit of a nice lead here, racking up almost a 100,000 point lead, I believe. But we are going to see a miss from Itzy, so that might make things change a bit here. But Toby missing again.
Toby's
probably not going
to
see much.
So much behind here in comparison to every single other player. He has 20,000 points.
Yeah, Toby definitely seems to be struggling. I mean, when he came in, he didn't seem particularly
Kurizu and Zach missing on that section, and North Korea and Flurry are still going.
That is going to give the possible point lead here to Germany.
That will definitely give the point lead in favor of Germany here, but a miss from Flutter, though, might change the deal a little bit. North Korea is still going insane with a 100%, with a full combo. Zach is finding more misses, and Kurisu just doesn't have enough combo to outbeat Notroy at all. And Scores is just edging a lot at this point, just because of Notroy. But a miss from him might be enough, I'm not too sure. Itze is trying his best, but I don't think it will be enough. There's not much time remaining. And that's a break from him as well. Kurisu dropping the combo for the United States too. And that means Germany will take the fourth point, breaking the hidden map. And as I said, baiting the US into picking a hidden map and actually taking it, despite Toby having a little bit of issues in that aspect.
Yeah, I think even if Toby fails, it's probably still going to be a point for Germany.
It still is.
Yeah. Kurisu failed.
I think he did. I'm not too sure, though.
Yeah, Kurisu failed, so...
But anyway, North Korea and Flutter, both two beating the US just by themselves.
Yeah, North Korea did really well. They pretty much doubling the best score from the US team. So yeah, that is going to take it to 4-3 for Germany. Germany breaking ahead and actually taking the lead for the first time.
Yep.
And it's their time to pick as well, so definitely a good position for Germany.
A very good position indeed, although...
Oh, here it goes.
I was trying to make that quick point.
Yeah. Bring it right to potential match. That's what Germany's going to do. They're going to try to put one quick nail in the coffin. But will they be able to?
See, again, I was kind of talking about this, maybe this being like a possibility, but I really wasn't sure. So even though I did kind of call it, I am still surprised I was right. It does seem kind of risky though. Because as you did say, Zetro, this could heavily backfire, so... We will definitely have to see how this goes.
Well, we'll know in about a minute.
Yeah, we'll know in about a minute. Yeah, looks like we have Zaxton now stepping out to set Delbeck in, and Toby will be replaced by Vinci, so... We should be ready to go just as soon as he plays ready up. Yeah, it's a pretty close match, so,
it's kind of refreshing to see it go back and forth like this. We haven't really seen it. It's been one-sided. Even though we did have an excellent match that went to tiebreaker, it was one-sided, then the comeback struggle was real, which was really awesome to watch.
Oh, yeah.
But here we're seeing both teams pretty evenly matched, taking point for point. It's just Germany got that upper hand on the United States with that last one, and they're going to try to push it a little bit further and extend that lead.
Yeah, do you reckon? Because like I said, this is the first time Germany's actually been in the lead. Do you reckon this is marking the end? Or do you reckon that this could still very well go to tiebreaker?
I feel like we'll definitely have a better idea after this minute of song.
Minute of pressure.
Yep. This one's straight pressure too, because a single mess up is it's over. But it's really good to have Dell there for double time. I don't think they have to worry about him dropping anything. Or at least not heavy. Ooh, there is a 3-4-way drop. Everyone on Germany and Dell. Itzy just dropped right there. Kurisu the only one holding a high combo at the moment, but that's all you really need in this one, as there's only half of the song left. As long as Kurisu can hold that a little bit higher and Dell and Itzy can get their combos up, we will see a 4-4. But Germany is ever inching closer to them. They have to be really careful. Flutter's combo's getting to a dangerous level. So is Kurisu, so is Itzy. Oh no, Kurisu dropped. That's going to be able to switch that over to Germany, but is there going to be enough time for their score to overtake? And it just
I think it will.
I don't know.
Oh, yeah, it definitely is. Holy crap,
oh,
now!
Oh no.
They did it. They took it. Even with a miss at the end by Bings, that's still a point for Germany.
Oh man, it worked for
That was a steal. They stole that point.
That was clutch.
Very much so. The clutch was real. Germany just locked that next point in. They're going to try to take this away. States has one chance for rebuttal here. They have to get a point, and then they're going to be back in Germany's playfield, and they have to hope that they're able to win on the pick that Germany decides.
I don't even know what US would go for here. I mean, they tried the head, and that kind of didn't work out as well as they thought it would. Nomad's kind of a very neutral zone. I mean, that could definitely go either side. I get the feeling that the teams are probably avoiding the last one. They could try the last Hard Rock if they feel like they want to risk it. And I'm pretty sure off that they're not going to want to even risk Green Green Dance. I don't know! Do they go for Coffins? Do they go for New? Not New, Noi?
If they go for Noi, it's going to be a death test.
Oh yeah, if they go for Noi, it's just going to be like who locked out the most. Lugfest 101. I feel like at the same time, if any team is going to pick Noi in this position, it would be the US, but there must be something better they can pick, but Milky, Ice Bear, and Woody and Teller aren't actually all that much better either. Like, pretty slow maps with the Hidden, so
they've exhausted most of the Nomad pool, haven't they?
Yeah, there's only the Oysama left. I feel like Coffins might be the better option. Who won Piranha?
Germany, I think.
Oh yeah, Germany did win it.
Like here's the thing, if you wanna go for the Hard Rock pick, the 6.5 CS, it's too big of a risk. Oh. And I don't think United States can afford that risk.
They're gonna go for Milky Ice Bear.
So going for a Hidden is a risky pick as well, but they have Zach, which is usually a good thing in your favor. Like, he knows how to handle low AR Hidden maps. The problem with the CS 6.5 is even if you're used to do that, you can miss.
Yeah, here's the thing,
USA didn't run, if I'm not mistaken.
No, Germany did, but here's the thing, one. Everything is a risky pick, not just this, but everything.
Yeah, I do agree with that, but Hidden is just less riskier than 6.5 CS.
They pulled out my buddy King Kevin.
Oh man, is King Kevin playing this?
Yep, and Hidden and low AR is his bread and butter. That's all he plays. So he is very specialized towards this kind of stuff. Hopefully he'll do very well. They're also bringing out Zach in the US, so the Hidden team, the Hidden players are coming out, the Hidden hitters, as you would spit.
They are not hiding themselves in the Hidden pool.
Alright, well, as we start this match, is this going to end up as a 6-3 for Germany, or can the United States pull ahead and claim that fourth point?
Well, now I'm going to impact, because I didn't realize Kevin was going to be playing, and I want to root for Zach, but I also want to root for Kevin. It's like, crap!
If Kevin carries this match, I'm just going to laugh so hard, and I will leave instantly, I think. Hope he can. Well, you have the first misses.
I haven't seen Kevin playing too much here lately, so I wonder how well his skills are. I do know AR8 and Hidden is his bread and butter, but it looks like he's having some issues. But I can't imagine him having a fun time at all. This is stressful. And
it feels like slower. Oh no, this doesn't feel like AR8, it feels slower. I don't know why.
That's
because the BPM is low and the Hidden.
And the BPM.
I thought it was AR8. 7.5 or something.
But overall, Germany is not performing so well on this one. US is doing really, really good in comparison. Like, they're not doing amazing, but it's more than enough.
Well, a lot of the that has to do with the fact that the core mechanics of how Catch the Beat's played now have been changed since this was ranked, and this is really just off-putting in terms of it. Like, if you grind out a lot of maps on a regular basis, just, you know, for score, for whatever reason, you're kind of used to what CTB is about now, and this is right before changes to hypers were made, so this gets a little bit awkward.
Definitely does. Like, but a fail can still happen though, because it's really easy to misread a whole pattern. So until the end, we cannot really tell. So far, US has the lead, and they will secure that until the end if no one fails. But it's about that, no one failing, and King Kevin HP bar is completely decreased into a point where he cannot clear the map. And that will leave US just 1 point away of the tiebreaker dream.
Oh, holy crap. This might actually happen again, boys. Boys, there might be a tiebreaker hype. Oh, it's going to be great.
Oh, straight to green, green dot. Okay. Okay. Okay.
I'm not surprised at all.
This should be good.
Wasn't this the same pick that Argentina took to enter a tiebreaker situation? Or is it just
Indonesia
me?
Picked this.
Yeah, but that was the last map of the match before the tiebreaker.
I cannot remember. Can you stick?
I think that was the case. And now Germany is picking that one as well. Same situation, same thing once again. I might just be crazy and this is another
Green Dance and then Ivor. So you're not, you were correct.
So if Destiny works, United States should take this one, force a tiebreaker, and then lose. But hopefully we will have a tiebreaker and we still don't know who won.
Well, it looks like we've got Toby coming back in, and Jimmy Rustler. I guess we're just waiting for the last few players to ready up, and then we should be good to go. Yep, there we go. We are ready to go with what could potentially be the final pick. Is this going to end up as a 6-4, or are we going to tiebreaker?
It is, no matter what, the last pick. The thing is, if it is the last map.
Yeah, that is very true. That is very true. Let's find out, but we do have Toby missing pretty early on, as well as Kreezer and Etsy, so...
No,
I thought United States were going to take the lead there, but no, Germany are going to take it straight back. And yeah, we do have a miss from Jim Russell as well, so all of the US team have actually dropped now, with Flutter and Notecore going very strong, so... This is actually looking to be a pretty good pick for Germany, but Notecore actually missing the Illusion Flutter, the only one with their full combo on a very impressive double S there.
Yeah, but combo advantage is quite undecisive right now. I think US is climbing back a little bit in terms of scoring, but the miss from Kurisu and Itzy, that definitely will hurt. Flutter now will be edging that lead further and further in favor of Germany. And if we don't see misses happening in Germany's side soon, this is the end of the US in the winner's bracket.
Yeah, let's I think see. Before the Itzy Kurisu drop, I think they did have the slight combo advantage there. So the fact that they both missed at the same time was really bad for them.
Yep, there you have first miss from the Germany side, Toby being the one missing. But that was the less important one, and Flutter now finding a miss. Now is US chance. They have a third of map remaining, and they have a comp advantage, a really huge one in actually. And they will be taking the lead back if they have enough time, which I think they have. It's just about keeping the combos for a little bit longer. Kurisu finding a miss over there and finding another one. But Itzy and Jimmy are refusing the misses. North Kuro is trying to pull back a little bit. And Itzy with a miss just before the US had that lead in the favor. Missed by Flutter. Jimmy Rustler now being the last hope for the United States to force a tiebreaker. North Kuro doing his face in order to just stop the possibility, and a miss from Jimmy Rossett at the end will seal the United States chances into I don't remember the war, but hey, oh my god.
That miss was pretty bad, and that is actually going to be 6-4 to Germany.
Coughing was the word I was looking for. Damn, I missed it.
And Zekrom appears right as the US have lost.
No!
Unlucky for Z-Trot. Unlucky there, buddy. But so that is actually going to be the end of today's matches. Give me one sec. Okay, yep, so we will be back tomorrow for the rest of the lower bracket encounters. So at 11 a.m. UTC, we will have South Korea versus Singapore, followed by France versus China at 12:30 p.m. So we've got two more awesome matches to present to you this weekend, but they will have to wait a bit, I'm afraid.
Yeah, but don't forget, Deadbeat, not only do we have those two great matches for you tomorrow, we'll also be unveiling the finals map full showcase as well. So be sure to be here tomorrow to find out what type of maps our contestants are going to be playing next week. That being said, we will be back at the times listed, and if you need to double check that, you can always check with the wiki. And remember, banners are still on sale, so if you want to support the teams or support a team, be sure to go ahead and pick up one of those banners. All proceeds will go to the prize pool for our contestants. With that being said, remember, rhythm's only a click away, and we'll see you all real soon.